Next program is analog to digital converter. Analog to digital converter. This is a kit to 8-bit interface ADC devices. So this is the device, the name indicates it's 8-bit ADC interface. So ADC means analog to digital converter. This is a 8-bit. So maybe you have seen 8-bit or 16-bit or 9-bit, 10-bit will be seen in the different cases. But in this kit, they actually given for the manufacturer for the 8-bit device. Okay. This is for the interfacing of 8051. This is the hardware. This contains all this in the single board. So the LCDs, ICs, all this bus, everything is connected here. So this, before connecting the 8-bit ADC, we have to connect the power supply for this device. This need for the 5-volt power supply. This need a 5-volt power supply. This is a, just connect the blue. This is a, see, this is a 5-volt here. 5-volt. This is a common. This is a ground. It's a ground. 12-volt. The minus 12-volt. Plus, minus, and minus 12 volt will be seen in this. They not connected these two buttons, these two wires. So only connected 5-volt and a ground. Right? For this device also, this will be connected directly for the power supply. This is a your wires will be connected from the same thing. Right? Now we have to see the code, how to execute the code. So this is a code to run the device. This will be this write the code ADC. Right. So analog to digital converter. So we need some channels and some need some digital conversion. This will be need all these things. This will be code will be explained in the classes. So this will be not needed to the explain in the lab. So this only how to execute the code I'll be explaining in the right now. Okay. Now we have to open this. So procedure everything is same. If you go to project, new image project, the file name, just how to giving everything is the same thing. Only just how to creating the name, just ending the different in the case here. Next, you have to open the Atmel flip. This is very important. You have to open this. How to execute? I just will be showing here. Right? You will just open the Atmel flip. Then you have to go to the file. So it's an IC. Select the 89582. Then say OK. This is done. Next, you have to select the COM port. It's very important. So select the COM port. This will be the COM3, and this is the 9600 baud rate. So very important, it will be the port and baud rate will be very important. This will be how to given the properly. Next, you have to say connect. Next, you have to load the hex file here. Let's load the hex file. This will be the already know the hex file. This is the experiment number 2 actually given. So whenever you give the file name, the first in the time of the code, this will be create the hex file the same name. Not the your ASM file name, it will be created in the your file name, what you given the project name, what you given, it is experiment number 2 is given here. The this is a, see here, this is given for the experiment number 2 is will be in the see in the top. This will be the experiment number 2. This will be create the hex file in the same thing here. Just have to create the hex file and say open. So once it's open the file, then you have to run it. It starts loading the all the files to the your 8051 kit. If this anything is not uploading, just you have to say just press the memory press button. Next you have to give the start application. Okay, so this is the part done in the previously in all the codes, right? Now you have to see the ADC part output. So this is going to see this, you have to open, there is a window, there is a flash magic. So you have to see the output in the serial terminal port. Just open the flash magic. Just you have to wait for some more time. This will be open the flash magic. So once this open the flash magic, for first step is to be select. Select in this 80C51. Just take this 80C51. In that 810C51RA2XX. This you have to select the these options. First is 80C51. Next is 89C51RA2XX will be selected. Then say OK. So once you select this, next you have to select the COM port and baud rate. This is very important. The COM port is 43 already selected. Then baud rate will be 9600. Okay. So next you have to go to the tools. Go to the terminal. So this also same the COM3 and the baud rate. Next you have to say OK. Next you have seen this here, the something will be giving the numbers here. FC, FD, FC, FD, it will be seeing there. So means this already is, now it is started. So ADC means you have to give, there is one pot here. Just there is a pot. So connect in the pot here. This is a pot, right? So this pot you have to vary. This is the given for the 5 kilo ohm pot. This you have to just vary it. Just how you will be varying, the numbers will be changing in the code. See it. Just I will be change this code. Just I change the numbers here. See here, this numbers will be DA, will be something will be saying. Something I will be change this. Again, this will be BAE, A4, 99, 85, 76, 67, 64. It's like you will be varying the pot. This is a, you have to convert the analog to digital converter. This pot is an analog. This pot is an analog in the nature. So this will be the your pot. This is the pot. So this you have to change the accordingly. Right, this is what you have to see in the, this is the terminal window. So how we will be changing the pot. See the pot, now I will changing the pot, these values will be changing the here. I will change the pot value here. This will change the values. Just see the window in the screen. Just I will change the numbers, just I change the window and just I change the pot value. It varies how its numbers will be varying. Right? So this is the how you are seeing the outputs in the ADCs, analog to digital converters. So this is how to, a very important concept, so only how to see the output by Atmel and Flashmagic with the terminal window. Right? So how to see these windows. So these are the program to execute how 8-bit ADC will be interfacing with the 8051. Thank you for watching.